Hello everyone, myself Ashish Desai, Assistant Professor, Mechanical Department. Today we are going to discuss here unit number 1, Testing and Evaluation. So in that content, we are going to discuss the types of hazards and process operation. So first of all, we look at the learning objective for the session. So first learning objective is to understand the hazard process operation. Second learning objective is to know the control of the process hazard analysis. So after this session, some learning outcome is there. So first learning outcome is the student will able to explain about the types of hazard. Then second learning outcome is the student will able to aware about controlling the process operations. So these are the learning outcomes. Now we going to discuss what is the hazard. So hazard is a potential for harm, and it is associated with a condition or activity that can be caused undesired consequences such as injury or illness. So this can be caused due to a harm or adverse effect on the health of individual or organization's property or equipment losses. So this is the impact of hazard, and it should be mostly happened in the different industries like oil and gas, petroleum industries, then you can say that in chemical industries. So this is the major impacted. Now first of all, we look at the types of hazards. So in that content, first is the chemical hazard. So this is the because of the chemical is contact with the person or operator. Then next, the physical hazard. So this type of hazard which is physically contact with machine or any other devices, handling devices, or maybe explosionary devices, then that should be happen a physical hazard. Next, biological hazard, that time when the worms or can say insect is contact with this human or in that person. So that to be impacted a biological hazard. Then ergonomics hazard. So in that content, if it is the machine as heavy or can say machine is at high length, high height, so that should be when they're operating the conditions, so that this is not suitable for the human. So that's why the human has more problems in the neck than in muscular pains. So that should be created because of the ergonomics features. So if it is not considered ergonomics features, so that should be affected on our operator or that person. The next is noise hazard. So nowadays the various noises is comes from the different machines. So that should be impacted on the human health services or can say human health. So this is major impact by the noise hazard. Now we going to discuss regarding the first, that is chemical hazard. So chemical can affect the skin by contact. Then it also enter our body either through inhalations or digestive system, and it should be affected in a the contaminants of water. So if it is the accumulation of chemicals is in contact with the water, fresh water or can say drinking water. So that should be impacted to the that aqueous animals, then operator, employees, organizations. So that should be affected or chemical hazards. So this is the term long term effect will be there due to the contact with water. Now we move for the next hazard. Then second hazard is a physical hazard. So this physical hazard will cause an injury risk on our body. So this should be categorized with confined spaces. So it by hit or flying objects, or can say caught it explosions, or can say hurt by collapsing the machinery, falling from heights, and tripping on obstacles. So this type of categorized in a physical hazards. So it should be majorly contacts with the different machines or can say different that instruments. So that time it causes the physical hazard. Nowadays the different machinery is available with us, as well as the robot system is there. So if it is in wrong in program, so that robo also major impact on one or can say that operator. So this is why we have to get contacts with the obstacles and make the proper arrangements for security. So this is regarding the physical hazard. Now we move for the biological hazard. So it may be refers to the harm to the health of living organisms, and that should be includes insects, bacteria, fungi, plants, animals and viruses. So this type of that hazards, it should be impacted on skin irritations, algae infections, then cancer, so etc. will be affected to the operators. The next is the hazard is ergonomics hazard. So whenever the designing of any component, if you do not consider the ergonomics features, so that should be affected on the muscular skeleton system of worker. So this injury caused by performing repetitive or can say forceful movements in a that posture movement in a that systems. So that should be improper work methods and improperty of design workstations, tools and equipment. So this is the major impact to the system. So while designing the any component, we can consider ergonomics features. So that should be easiest method for eliminating the ergonomics hazards. Now the next is the noise hazard. So the noise hazard can be disturb the concentration, or can say interfere with communication and result in a loss of hearing. So that should be high impact on noises, and it is particular damaging. The next, noise can be masked out of signals that can be affecting the communications with others. So this should be happen in the noise hazards. Nowadays the different devices we can use over here for eliminating the noise levels. So we can construct the wall as per the conditions, so that can be eliminate the noise hazards. So different methods we can use there. Then different machines with available with foundations. If you provide the foundations to that machine, so it can not make a noise. So this is the important factor. Now we move for hazard analysis. So first of all, we identify the hazards. So in that we can determine the hazard and hazard events of the equipment under control and control systems. So this is the methodology for analyzing the hazards. Then next, identify the causes. So why it may cause. So it can sequencing leading to the hazardous events identified. So this is regarding the identify causes. Then determine the risk. So it should be associated with hazardous events. So this should be also we can consider as and determine the risking. Then next, so these are the objective we can find out here, that is identify hazards, second is the identify causes, and third is a determine the risk. So this type of analysis will be done in a hazardous conditions. So while defining the different process or that safety features, always remember that the company will be mentions the hazardous conditions. Suppose welding structures were provided for the pressure vessels. So at that time, the checking of the eye, it should be compulsion one. Then also training of the that particular person is required over there. So that according to that, they should be completed or in that sessions. So this is the major impact on we can identify the causes, and we can take the actions against that causes. And then next we can determine the risk also. So whenever we can go for better process, so there will be different risks will available with us. So this is the process we can follow for the hazard analysis. Now we move for the importance of hazard analysis. So here in that benefits of the hazard analysis to train the workers how to do their job safely. So this is the beneficiary for hazardous analysis. So if you train the people or workers, then automatically the jobs will be saved, and then policy mix will be improved. then it should be impacted on investigation of accidents, then it should be increasing the quality and decrease the injury rate. So this is the flow chart for importance of hazard analysis. So we know that the trained peoples should be do the increasing the quality features, as well as it should reduces the injury rate. So this is the major impact to the hazardous analysis. For that purpose, we inquired the investigations of accidents. So this is the special feature in hazardous analysis. And here we, before that, we have to make a policies and procedure of improvement. So this is where we will help to find out the hazardous analysis. Now we move for the personal protective equipments. So this is a categorized for hearing protection. So we can use the headphones, or can say the cotton balls, and then we have to avoid the hearing of this system. The next, eye protections. So for eye protections, we can wear the goggles. The next, for hand purpose, we can protect with the hand gloves. The next, this eye protections, we can wear the foot protections, material handling aids. So this is the important personal protective equipment is there. So as per our requirement, we can follow it. Suppose the mining industry is there, then food protection is required over there with the eye protections. So if you have a pressure vessel and that welding structures will be there. So if you, because that number of sheets is available with us, and with the help of that, we can use over the pressure vessels. So these pressure vessels, we can weld it over there. So that's why we can require the eye protections. So different companies we can that take eye protections, and then we can implement in the that particular systems for performing the operations. Then next is the hand protections. So for hand protections, we can wear the, already know that we can wear the hand gloves. Then next, respiratory protections. So here, whenever the oxygen's rate is zero or it should be negligible, then we can use a respiratory protection systems. So this is the personal protective equipments we can handle over the that different equipments. So if it is any problem with us for the protecting the that services, then we can use personal protective equipments. Now we controlling the hazardous. So this is the important factor. So how to control this hazardous? So this is the order, or can say precedence, can control following the conditions. Exam, that first one is engineering controls. So we can provide engineering controls, and then we have to control the hazardous. Second is administrative hazardous. So this is also important for controlling the hazards. Then personal protective equipment. So already I mentioned about this personal protective equipment. This is regarding the controlling the hazards. So while studying of this hazardous conditions, we have to go for different types of hazardous, and how to control this that hazards, it is also important. So first is the engineering controls, then second is the administrative controls, and third one is the personal protective equipment. So first of all, we know that the controlling the exact or that hazards, it should be more and more effectiveness. So first of all, we prefer PPE, that is personal protective equipment. Then we go for administrative and work that practice controls, and then go for engineering controls. So these are the flow chart, or can say that apex body for the hazardous conditions. So as per our requirement, we can check the effectiveness of for the controlling the hazards, or can say control the hazards. Now we move then out to the administrative and work practice controls. The next is the engineering controls. So likewise, we can follow it, and then effectiveness will be increases. The next, the engineering controls. So here we can discuss regarding engineering controls. So how to eliminate of the hazards. So we can provide the equipments, and we can decrease the hazards. Then isolation of the hazards. So while the machines available with us with guards, or it is not available, then we can put up the foundation blocks like that. We can eliminate the hazardous isolations then removal of redirection or reorientation of the hazard, such as local and exhaust ventilation. So this is also impact to the engineering controls. So this type of activity we can conduct over here for administrative controls. So here we can return operating procedures, is there work permits and work safe work practices there for administrative work or consider administrative controls, monitoring the use of highly hazardous material, alarm signs and warning is required over there, then buddy system and training is there, then explosive time limitations for heat stress and ergonomic hazards, we can eliminate this. Now we move for the next, that is the personal protective equipment. So this is acceptable as a control method. When engineering controls are not feasible, then you can go for personal protective equipment. While the engineering controls are being developed and when safe work practices do not provide the safe or can say sufficient additional protections. So this is called as PPE or can say personal protective equipment. Now we move for the job hazard analysis. So as we know that at the time of operations, we can go for number of conditions. So first of all, we focus on the relationship with the worker and the task. The task to the tools and the tool environment. Then techniques that focuses on job tasks as a way to identify the hazards before they occur. So this is also major impact. Whenever it has happened, before that you can say preventive measures we can take first. So this is the way of conduction of the hazardous analysis. Then next is identify the hazards. So we can identifying the product or can say process or applications, and then we can create the hazardous analysis. The next technique to identify the dangers or of specific task in order to reduce the risk of injury or workers. So we here identify the dangerous point, and you have to find out here the task in order to reduce the risk of injury to workers. So this is the job hazards analysis. So as per our requirement, we can go for this, and then we can analyze the hazardous conditions. Now we know that the process. So process is maybe series of mechanical or chemical operations or matter in order to change the preservative. This is about process. Then process engineering. It can focuses on design, operation, control, and optimization of chemical, physical, and biological processes. So this is nothing but a process engineering. So here we can focuses on design, or can say control, then optimization of chemical, physical and biological of processes. So this should be impacted on hazardous process engineerings. The next, process safety. So it should be focuses on application of safe engineering and design principles, safe operating practices, proper preventing controls. And nextly, that is the process engineering. So it can focuses on design, operations, control and optimization of chemical, physical and biological processes. The next is a process safety. So always know that the it focuses on the application of the safe engineering and design principles. So safe operating practices, then proper preventing measures we can take here. Then we go for the processes that can be potential to cause harm by uncontrollable releasing the hazardous conditions or material conditions. Then it an example of that releases the hazardous materials, that loss of containment, uncontrollable release the energy, explosion or fire will be takes place. So this is the why we can check out here. Then process safety management. So it can differs aspects of risk in a facility and put up the under control of management system. The next is by establishing a risk-based awareness, the safety impacts of technology, personnel and the management of the system provides a dynamic environment or continuous improvement. So this is regarding the process safety management. Now we have to observe here, that is process hazard identification and risk analysis. So here this is the method. So first, this is mechanical integrity, employee participation, incident investigation, compliant audits, then pre-startup safety review, then that contractors, then training, then we go for offer to the operator, training is there, then operating procedure is there, then management of change. So there are different policies over there, so according to that we can change that processes, and process safety information, then mechanical integrity, so, or you can say employee participation. So this will be help for the process hazard applications, or you can say identification. Then look at the process hazards. So it should be physical data, reactivity data, then corrosive data, chemical, or can say thermal stability data, and effect of mixing, that is the last case. So these are the available the hazardous conditions. Now we move for the process technology. So in that content we have to go and discuss the block flow diagrams. So whenever the enter into the system for maintenance purpose, or you can say you have to construct new product, so at that time this process technology we have to take the under the considerations over here, that is block flow diagram. So we have to draw this diagram and we have to resend it, right? So process in chemistry, then maximum intended inventory, safe upper lower limits, that is for temperature, pressure, or so this is about the process technology. So already we have discussed here safe upper or lower limits, that is temperature, pressure, flow compensation, or you can say compositions. So according to their use usage, the process we can evolve over here. Then evaluations of consequences of deviations, then process equipment, so material of construction, mapping and instrumentation diagrams, electrical classification, relief system design, ventilation system design, design codes and standards, material and energy balances, then safety systems for interlocks and detections. So these are the process equipments we have observed here. Thank you. So in next lecture we will discuss regarding the process equipment, that things. Okay, thank you.